And you play?
I play BJ.
Okay. And when you first read Crazy Bitches, the script, you know, you were either coming in for an audition or maybe you'd already been hired. What did you think of the story in it?
I loved it. I thought it was funny, scary, and I thought it was fresh, too. It was a new type of story. It's not something that I'd read before. I thought it was a really creative idea. I love the underlying message about vanity and I just think it had a good message of how each character ends up dying and how that is threaded in through the story and then how it ends up happening in the end. I thought it was really cool.
When you think of some sort of classic horror films, perhaps like a Saw or Friday the 13th, how is Crazy Bitches different from those types of movies?
Well, I think Crazy Bitches has humor in it, which I really loved, because I'm not particularly a fan of straight horror movies. I don't like going to the movie theater to be scared, just freaked out. I love Scream, because there is comedy infused into it. And then I guess horror films, I'm more into sci-fi. I like, you know, 2001 A Space Odyssey, Rosemary's Baby, that's kind of like a classic horror. So I'm more into the classic horror films, and I feel Crazy Bitches is, it's a mesh of so many things, and that's what makes it so great, because it's a fresh idea. It's something that you don't see get done very often. And that's what I really loved about the script, because it does take a lot of the, because it is scary. I mean, there's moments that are really scary, but it takes a lot of the things from classic horror films, and it makes something really new and fresh. And that's what I just loved about the script, loved about working on the film.
How does BJ fit into the story, and what did you like about playing BJ?
BJ is a great character to play. I feel he has so many funny moments, and he's kind of like the jester. So he just he makes comments on a lot of what's going on, and it's great that the character is a great fit in the script, because he has his own web series, so he lets the audience know where we're at, what's going on, when we get to a certain place, the history of that place, and it's all done through his web series. And so, and then he's just such a smartass. he's such a guy who just calls everyone out on their stuff.
When Jane told you your character's going to be named BJ, what did you think?
BJ. Blow job. I think it's hilarious. His name's BJ Johnson, which is like, it's so funny. And it really infuses a lot of the character, and he was just so much fun to play. It was just so much fun to play. I feel that also because BJ is in front of the camera, he's a bit of a diva, he's really vain, and because of all of those things, as an actor, you can push the envelope. You can do things and say things and make choices that really push the envelope, and that's what was so fun playing about him.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, you mentioned that he's vain. What is Andy Gala's biggest vanity?
The left side of my face. So anytime I'm working on any film or any project, I always try to just lean in left and get coverage on this side.
When you hear the word bitch or bitches, is that a good word or a bad word? What do you think?
I feel like I as a man feel uncomfortable saying it sometimes, you know. But I think in the context of camaraderie that it's fun, you know. It's a fun word. I feel, you know, it's what you make of it. You know, it's how you take it and it's what you make of it. But I thought it was funny. I thought it was funny playing BJ and you know, just being one of the gals, and it's a different experience.
Who's the bitchiest of the bitches?
Probably BJ.
And why?
Because he's sassy. You know, he just tells it like it is, and he's not gonna take anyone's shit. Like, he's gonna just tell it how it is, and he's a bit of a diva. So I think he just kind of lays it down when he needs to.
Have you ever walked into a situation or seen a situation or seen somebody and there's a touch of envy in you, perhaps, and you say, hey, I just want to kill that bitch?
Yeah. Well, recently I've been trying to gain weight, so I'm like going to the gym and everything. And you know, I'm just not genetically made up to be a bodybuilder. Like, I just can't, like, you know, get that big. So, you know, there's this gym I go to, and there's these dudes who just spend all day at the gym, and I'm like, I hate you. Like, how do you guys get your muscles, like, that big? And so I think that's where a little, you know, bitchiness comes out in me.
Great. And when I say the word popcorn movie, what comes to your mind?
I think fun. A fun movie, something that you do on a Friday night with friends, something where you go to the movies to just enjoy yourself, have fun, laugh, and go away when you leave the theater you learn something. You learn something as well. But it's not like it was a message that was pounded. It was more, it's not like you went to a history lesson. It's something where you had fun, you had a good time, you went with your friends, you ate popcorn, ate candy, laughed, maybe cried a little, and then when you left a little wiser.
Yeah. Crazy Bitch is a popcorn movie, do you
think? Absolutely. Absolutely. It is a brilliant popcorn movie because it has all of those elements. You know, you laugh, you cry, you get aroused in some scenes, and then when you leave the theater, you really take away a message and you're a bit wiser.
You say you get aroused. There's a lot of eye candy in
the
movie. Who's the most eye candy?
All of the women. They're so beautiful. Each one of them. They are so incredibly gorgeous, and that was my favorite part working on the film, including the director. She's gorgeous too. So I just had. There was so much eye candy around, and I was the only guy, so I was just in heaven. You know, it was great.
Last one. Do you, when you go to movies, do you read reviews and criticism and critics? And if so, how much do they influence your movie choices?
I do. I used to read reviews a lot, and I would only go to movies based on what I read in reviews. And then an interesting thing happened. I would see certain movies early in the year, and I would go because of particular actors in it or the performance was good, and they wouldn't get nominated. And in my opinion, that's who I had my money on. Like, I was like, this guy's going to win it this year, and then they'd get snubbed when it came to award season. So after that, I got a little discouraged, or not discouraged, but in the sense of, like, I don't really believe the reviews get it right all the time. In fact, a lot of times they don't. Sometimes it's hype that ends up creating it. Someone writes one good review, and then it just kind of snowballs from there. So I used to really pay attention to the reviews, but now I don't as much because I see so much good stuff, so many great performances that don't get recognized or don't get reviewed in the right way. And then I see stuff that's really mediocre be like the darling. And so it really makes me question the effectiveness or how true these reviews really are.
Talk a little bit about working with Jane as a director. What are her strengths, do you think, and how did that manifest itself on the set of Crazy Bitches?
Jane is an amazing director to work with. I think the main thing that I really loved working with her, even from the moment I auditioned for the film, is she's an actor, and she's a really, really good actor, and that's her background. So as an actor coming in, she really understands the process. She creates a safe environment where I feel comfortable taking risks, you know, making character choices. And that's the thing. You want to, there's no fear at all on set either, which is really helpful. And when you're shooting a film like this, you have one or two takes and you got to move on. And so it's really important to feel comfortable, feel that you can take a risk. And if something isn't working, then I trust Jane that she can lead me in the right way. Where I don't feel as much pressure because I feel I can really go out there, just let it all out, and then Jane will guide me in the right way. And that's the real gift of working with her. It's just that she really understands the process of what we go through as actors. And it's nice. It just makes the whole process and the film and everything about it just so much better and such a joy to work on.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Perfect timing.
Yeah, it was.